is an accredited study program. Follow us and you'll be free from all belief. You'll be free from knowledge. You'll be free to share that with others.
What? This is lunacy.
Your hostility is really depressing, Laszlo.
You see clearly, Michelle. Laszlo, there's a mountain up there. Let me show you the way.
Listen, dude, I've been to the mountaintop. Resort in Guatemala or a war zone. You're on the way down, so you get desperate. You do more and more insane things for ratings. You don't care, but it's no good. The public doesn't love you anymore. Nobody loves you. There's a great hole of lovelessness inside you. You're just a shell. Nobody cares. Your friends are more successful than you. They won't call you back. They don't even re-bleep you anymore. Your life invader friends start to go down. The private members clubs tell you that you're no longer welcome because tried to speak to a movie star there. Well, I was a star once, okay? I was, but it's no good. It keeps going down. It's okay. It just keeps going.
Child.
It's not okay. Your producer calls you up. Someone made up some pictures that seem to show you, you know, being spanked in a brothel. That's not true. They could put my head on any dude's body. I'm much bigger than that. It's computers. There weren't any cameras in there, you know. And then they start calling you a misogynist in the press and on Bleeder. You know, it's not true. Laszlo loves women. I love women. They call me gay, and that's not true. Laszlo's a man. He has a man's needs. Only it still keeps coming. The great wall of shame and the self-loathing just flows on and on like you're on the ground, and there's just a group of men urinating on you. But it's a hypothetical urination. Then one day your producer comes in and says, Laszlo, even though you've been a syndicated radio host for a long time, and even though you're great, now you're gonna be the co-host.
The assistant to the host.
Shut up, okay? You won. You're perky. You're young. You look great. And I'm the assistant to the host of a woman with literally nothing to say.
I get it. You did a mountain of blow in the 90s. No one cares.
It was fantastic, okay?
I'm glad you had blow all over your nose for many years.
You don't have a catchphrase.
I don't need one. And nobody gives a shit.
I was big in the 90s. I remember .com. And we used to program computers like C:\, and HTTP forward, 10, print, hello, 20, go to 10.
The great terror of time is something we cover in our study program, my child.
Just leave me alone, all of you.
There. Sometimes in the valley, we can see the mountain through the clouds. That's what makes us its children.
I don't understand valleys or clouds. It sounds like a nursery rhyme.
Oh, you take a minute, Laszlo. Man. Listen, anyone saying the male menopause is a myth, just remember this moment, please.
It's very simple. You just work through a very cost-effective program and achieve limitless joy.
That sounds wonderful. Laszlo, stop crying.
I'm not crying.
Well, thank you, Brother Adrian. Your seminar seemed very interesting.
Yes, sir.
But I think we've run out of time on Chattersphere.
I love you, Michelle. Oh. This has been the Chattersphere with Michelle and Laszlo.
up. I'm not barren. Who even uses the term barren? What are you, King James Bible?
I am Dr. Ray D'Angelo Harris, Bible of Duality. That's why I am. Radio Ray Jesus. Speak to me about your issues on the mind, body, and spirit. And who's next? I said, who's next?
Station.
Wake up, girl. Come on, now. Are you with me or not? You're not with me right now. Your mind is somewhere else. Your mind is in the gutter.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to offend your duality, Dr. Ray. Line 5.
No, girl, you slow up now. Slow up a second, right? What'd you say to me? What'd you say to me?
Back up! Line 5.
Would you disrespect my duality? Would you? Because this is, I'm a spiritual being. If you want to push me, if anybody wants to push me, you'll find out there's a whole lot more to Dr. Ray D'Angelo Harris than a doctorate from a respected university and a string of successful books and a top body health show. If you want to go there, woman, you want a piece of me? If you want a party, huh? Because I know things. I know them. Dumb things. I know dumb things, and dumb things know me, and therefore dumb things don't know that I know those things. So I know dumb things because dumb things is right in front of my face. I'll tell the audience.
Calm down, Ray. You're getting all angry again. I wasn't disrespecting your duality. It's this smoothie you need. I'm kind of bugging out.
That's because it's Dr. Ray D'Angelo Harris Bug Out Smoothie with Spirulina, which is nature's PCP. I'm sorry, Cheryl. You know I love you,
Booga,
but sometimes you need to yell that. Cheryl, right now! Right now! Right now! Get it! Get it! I'ma catch... Don't do it on the air! Don't do it! Now look, I'ma catch it in my hand, and my thighs in your mouth. Open your mouth.
Okay.
Open your mouth, man!
Hey!
No! You open your mouth, I'ma throw you my arm, and my arm gonna go in your mouth. Open your mouth, why?
Okay. Alright.
Catch it! You gotta catch it! You ain't catching
on! Hey!
Catch it now! You caught it. That's what I want you to do. I still love you. Cheryl, don't ever correct me on the air. Don't you ever correct my knowledge on what public radio is. I'm on public radio every day, cleansing people, cleansing their soul, taking them on journeys. And I'm not going to let you tell me this flight is full. I'm not going to do it, Cheryl. I'm not going to let you offer me $300 to get on the next available flight. I'm not going to do it, Cheryl. You know why? Because I want to fly today. It ain't gonna happen, Cheryl. Not in front of my public, and not in front of my listeners, and not in front of no people out there who I'm cleansing through their ass. It's not gonna happen.
You are a bully, Ray.
Look, girl, this be strong, okay? I'm sorry I went there, but sometimes I gotta go there to get there. You understand what I'm saying? I gotta go out there. Here's how it works, Cheryl. Let me explain to you how it works in front of everybody, in front of all my listeners.
Okay.
I gotta go through these airwaves, out to the people, touch the people. Through their ears, into their ears, into their brain, down their system, their nervous system, into their chest, to help their heart beat, down to their bowels, right? To stir things up in their bowels. You understand? That's a cleansing. That's a damn cleansing. They sit on that toilet bowl, side saddle, and put one elbow on that flusher. You understand? Because everything's coming out. You know what? I'm getting Lionel back. Lionel's a damn good producer. Who's on the line? Please tell me it's Lionel. Lionel, you calling for your job back? Lionel!
Ray, I love the
the vibe, but it's mostly bullshit.
What the hell? We are raising awareness around here.
Who's on the phone, and how can we go beyond insemination?
My name ain't important.
Oh, it's my old friend Clarence, everybody. You son of a gun. Clarence is a stand-up guy. I say that even though he is in a wheelchair. Clarence and I fought in the war together, right on the front lines of the war on terror. We'd drive around at night and join a cold one. If we saw a foreigner acting squirrely, we called 911 right after we shot him.
Dwayne, I got good news. I don't need the wheelchair no more.
It is a miracle. My prayers have been answered. Many a time when I was down on both knees giving a working girl the business, my mind would turn to you and that you are a cripple that can't enjoy the pleasures of the flesh.
No, no, I don't need a wheelchair because I got a motorized scooter now. The Relax Power X from Ambulance.